We're here on our farm, Boggy Creek Farms in Scriven, Georgia. We're predominantly a cow-calf operation. And when this farm was first instated in 1941, my grandfather, Julian Griffis, bought the first piece of property that belongs to this farm. It started out as a hog farm and row crops. We grew cotton, corn, tobacco, soybeans, wheat, and hogs. And we had 200 sows fair to finish all my growing up years. And we started really incorporating the cattle part of it into our operation in the late 1980s. My dad really had a passion for livestock more than row cropping. So as time went on, we planted more and more of our cultivated ground into grass and just kept adding cows. So today, everything we own is in grass. We roll about 6,000 rolls of hay a summer, not only on our farm, but for other folks. We do some custom bale work too. And we've got about 350 mama cows that we run here on our farm. My journey to where I am now with Georgia Cattlemen started 7 years ago. David Gosda, who was the current president of Georgia Cattlemen at that time, he called me and asked me would I be willing to serve on the executive committee. The year prior to that, I had gone to what they call the Emerging Leaders Conference that Georgia Cattlemen puts on in January of every year. And you stay there in Macon at the office and up at the Capitol for 3 days, and you really learn what Georgia Cattlemen's and the Georgia Beef Board are and what they do, how they serve the producers of Georgia, as well as National Beef Cattle Association, NCBA, and what it does nationwide. So I had done that, and I had expressed to Josh White that if there was ever a place that I would be excited to do more to serve the industry here in Georgia. So David Gosda called and asked would I be willing to serve on the executive committee, and of course I said yes, and that was 7 years ago, and I served, and then they asked me to move up to vice president 3 years ago, and then I was president-elect last year, and now I am the current Georgia Cattlemen's president. Well, you know, I'm the second female president of Georgia Cattlemen's Association. Ms. Betts Berry was president in 1998, so it had been exactly 20 years when I took office in April, since a female had been at the helm, if you will, of the Georgia Cattlemen's. You know, to me, it just means that more doors are being opened. I know that all across ag, not just meat production, but all across ag, you're seeing more and more and more females operating farms. So it just opens those doors, and I want to say that it shows my 13-year-old daughter that anything's possible if you work hard. I've had people ask me on multiple occasions, you know, how did you get where you are? Why are you doing a man's job? And I simply tell them, my dad never told me I was a girl, that I wasn't supposed to do it. He never said, that's too heavy, don't pick it up. He never said, you know, that calf's too fast, don't run him down. So I just did. I always did what everybody else did, whether they were a man or a woman. So, you know, to me, I just feel like it's another step on the ladder I've been trying to climb and being a successful beef producer. And if it encourages some females to pursue things that they think they might not can do, then that's fantastic. I'm really excited about it.